Today we're going to release Vilanzo. He's a Florida manatee that's been at the Jacksonville Zoo and Gardens for the past 8 weeks, and he's been treated for cold stress.
So Vilanzo was rescued on Vilano Beach, and he was beached actually on the beach. He came in a little bit thin. You can tell by looking at his body. He looked a little thin. He had a flat belly, and temps were pretty cold at that point. The water temp was cold, and he was experiencing cold stress. We sort of equate it to frostbite in humans. We'll see lethargy, lesions on the body, kind of white areas, skin sloughing off, sometimes sort of ulcerated looking areas. And then those are the real signs you see externally. Vilanzo has been quite active for the last couple of weeks. So he's been gaining weight like a champ. This is the first local release, so it's another big day for us. But any release is certainly a big day for the center.
Good. So when we were riding in the truck, I noticed that some of the staff were actually putting water on his face. What did that do?
Yeah, so manatees can breathe on their own outside of the water and they're fine, but sometimes you just want to stimulate a breath if it's been a while just to get rid of some of that built up CO2. We actually stimulate them breaking the surface of the water, and then that makes them take a breath and then you know that they've cleared. So after we unload them from the truck, we actually have a couple steps before we release them into the water. And that includes doing final measurements, so getting girth measurements, for example. And then also I marked up his scars and took good quality photos. Those can then be added to our photo ID catalog, and we can hopefully ID this animal in the future if we ever run across him again.
One, two, three.
It's definitely a positive end, and to see him splash his tail at the end was what we want to see.